Hey guys, happy Saturday. Oh, Saturday night's all right for fighting. Get a little action in. That's not my usual day today, but I said I'd take over for Jessica, who is at cause and effect right now. So hi to her and everyone who went. I hope you're having a good time. Yeah, I decided to switch with her since Tuesday was kind of not a great day for me, and yeah. Anyway, so on Wednesday I got surgery on my head. Probably see stitches, maybe. I got 10 stitches in all. I got two little holy thingers. And it wasn't anything bad. It was just cosmetic surgery to get rid of a couple genetic type bump thingers. And yeah, it hurts a lot. Actually, I didn't think it would hurt this much, and it really, really does. So yeah, 10 stitches. If you can beat it, let me know. Yeah, so to add insult to injury, there's been a family of crows that have, like, taken up residence in our tree out back, and they're teaching their, like, I guess they're young, their chicks, they're teaching their chicks how to fly and, you know, hunt and take care of themselves and whatever, but they're so loud, and they wake me up almost every morning, just, kah, 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 kah. Here's an example. So, come have a listen. Let me see if I know. Okay, so I don't know if you can hear that. You probably can, because it's really annoying. There's like three of those little squawkers living in our tree. This hasn't stopped for at least a week. It's driving me crazy. And when threatening other crows come into the yard, they fight for like half an hour. And I mean, most of you are kind of aware that I have a bit of a crow phobia. They just won't shut up. And I know it's nature, and I know it's great that they're taking care of their babies and everything. However, dear God, I kind of have a phobia of crows, which stemmed from this incident. Here, I've redone it in cartoon form so you can see what happened. So yeah, I basically got chased by crows a long time ago, and it kind of scarred me for life a little bit. I mean, I'm not terrified of them, and I can walk past them and everything, but if they're cawing over my head, I get kind of nervous. So yeah, that's why I'm not exactly really happy with them moving into my yard. So yeah, they're really loud, and they're really annoying, and they're kind of obnoxious, and I kind of wish that they would go away, but I'm kind of happy that they're taking the time to take care of their babies. There's the phone. So, I went out and looked up some information on crows to maybe make myself feel better and maybe inform myself a little more. So, usually the mother sits on the eggs and she lays them, and there takes, like, a couple days for them to hatch. So, they'll start hatching, and it'll be 3 days between the first chick and the last chick. At 30 to 40 days old, they can leave the nest and, you know, start trying to fly and whatnot, so I'm guessing that's how old these crows are here. But for the next 3 to 4 months, they kind of rely on their parents still to teach them stuff. And what I found really interesting is the families have, like, helper crows and stuff. So, like, the two parent crows, they'll mate for life, and when they have chicks, their chicks the year after will take care of their second chick generation. And so that's why there's so many crows all in these big bunches, is because there's family units of them. So that's kind of interesting. Crows are really smart. They can problem solve and stuff like that. In Japan, they had some research done, and they actually found that they were pretty much almost as smart as dolphins or whatever. They had problem solving skills, and they would adapt to certain situations in order to solve their problems. So they're really smart. And then I was reading this other thing online, and it said that crows are able to recognize faces better than most animals. So if one crow feels threatened by someone or they're trying to take their eggs or whatever, the crows will kind of let each other know who that is. And then they'll kind of recognize you if you walk by and they don't like you. They're all kind of huddle up and be kind of mad at you. And the same as if you're kind of good to them, they'll follow you for food and stuff like that. I thought that was kind of interesting. But they're in my yard and they won't shut up. So, pot shots with BB guns? Anyone? Anyone got a BB gun I can borrow? No, that would be mean. I guess I'm just gonna have to put up with it till they leave. But, yeah, so that's some information on crows. I hope everyone has a good time at Cause and Effect. Kathleen, you drew me a picture. I'm not sure if you have it on your video or not. I haven't watched it yet, but I will have your picture for next week since I talked about crows this week, and I'll see you later. Hopefully you liked my cartoon, and yeah, that's it.